Chapter 18, edited for anybody reading along. Manjeet Patel heard the sobbing from his wife even before he opened the door to his house. Entering the one-room tenement in the Dharavi slums of Mumbai, he found his wife seated on the floor, rocking a young child in her arms. "What is the matter, Pratima?" The woman looked up, tears on her cheeks. "It is the baby. He has been violently ill all day." Patel examined the child. Just under the age of 2, the boy was hot and limp in his mother's arms. His bulging eyes were dull and listless. Patel touched his son's head and then pinched his arm, noting the skin felt hard and rubbery. "We must take him to the clinic." The weary man, who made his living driving a tuk-tuk in the streets of Mumbai, helped his wife to her feet with child in arms. They exited their tin-roofed house and trudged down a muddy lane littered with trash and reeking of assorted odors. 6 blocks away, they reached a small clinic. Passing through its glass doors, they were aghast to find the waiting room crammed with people, nearly all clutching a baby or toddler in their arms. Patel made his way to the admissions desk. "My son, you'll have to wait," an elderly woman behind the desk cut him off. She waved a hand toward the waiting room. "They are all sick." Patel signed an admittance sheet, then shuffled back to his wife, who had found a spot on the floor. They waited nearly an hour before a young woman in a white coat appeared and began examining the patients in the waiting area. "There's no more space in the examination room," she announced. "Just stay where you are and I'll come to you." The room had swelled to overflowing by the time she reached the Patels. The doctor took their son's pulse, then called to an assistant. An intravenous solution bag was brought over and the doctor injected a line into the boy's arm. "Hold this up," she instructed, passing the bag to Patel. "The boy, will he be all right?" he asked. "Yes, I think so. You are lucky. You brought him in when you did." "Is it cholera? We are careful with the water." The doctor nodded. "Care does not matter in this instance. The entire city seems to be infected, even Bandra, and more lethal than usual." She motioned her eyes toward a woman in a green shawl behind her, then quickly moved on to the next patient. Patel sat with his wife on the floor, keeping the IV bag elevated. As he waited to see signs of improvement in his son, he glanced at the woman in the shawl. She sat across the room, mumbling to herself while rocking an infant in her arms. Patel caught a brief glimpse of the baby and saw with sadness that it was dead. The mother had refused to give it up, however, and sat rocking on the floor for hours. It would not be the last dead child he would witness. A steady stream of parents left the clinic in grief, unable to save their young children from the quick-striking disease. The overworked doctor circled back some time later and removed the empty IV bag. "Your son looks better. I'm afraid that is all I can do for you. Take him home and keep him hydrated." "Thank you, doctor." Patel steadied his son with relief. His eyes were fully open now, and he seemed to have more strength. Patel just felt it in his bones. His son would be one of the lucky ones. The tuk-tuk driver helped his wife up and stepped to the door. Something had bothered him since he had arrived at the clinic, and he hesitated at the door in search of an answer. He looked around the crowded room, studying the parents and their sick children. It took a moment for him to realize what was wrong, and then it struck him. All of the sick children in the clinic were boys.